Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a show where we'll provide you fresh insights into South Asia's geopolitical, strategic and security situation. Let's take a look at the headlines first. Pakistani nationals arrested with narcotics off Gujarat coast. Hatred pushing minorities in Pakistan to the periphery. And Indian security forces intensify counter-terrorism efforts in Jammu and Kashmir. During a cooperative operation in India, the Narcotics Control Bureau and the Anti-Terrorist Squad apprehended 14 Pakistani nationals near the Gujarat coast, seizing 86 kilograms of illicit drugs valued at rupees 71 million from their possession. During the operation, the Pakistani nationals attempted to run their boat over the ATS officials in an attempt to avoid being arrested. In response, they opened fire. Subsequently, the suspects were captured. A report.
On April 28, the Indian Coast Guard intercepted a suspicious Pakistani boat that was carrying drugs worth $71 million. Acting on intelligence, the Coast Guard, along with the Anti-Terrorism Squad and the Narcotics Control Bureau, launched a crackdown on the drug trafficking syndicate operating in the region. Along with the drugs, 14 crew members from the Pakistani vessel were also detained. According to reports, all the 14 accused are residents of Las Bela in Pakistan's Balochistan. The master of the boat, 62-year-old Nazir Hussain Azam Khan, who suffered the bullet injury, was evacuated for further medical care. Footage released by the Indian Coast Guard showed the vessel being surrounded and circled by a ship from the Gujarat Anti-Terrorist Squad, the detainees with bags over their heads being led off their vessel.
We have caught 14 Pakistani nationals along with 86 kg of contraband, which includes 18 packets of methamphetamine and 68 packets of heroin, total weighing about 86 kgs. I think the international market value should be around 600 crores.
Various illicit drugs, including heroin, opium and hashish, are produced or trafficked through Pakistan. The country serves as a transit route for drugs originating from neighboring Afghanistan, one of the world's largest producers of opium. Pakistan is using drones to ferry narcotics material into India, particularly in the region of Jammu and Kashmir. After the serious crackdown against hawala operators in recent years, Pakistani agencies are using narcotics to fund terrorism in the valley. Indian authorities, including law enforcement agencies, have been actively engaged in combating PAK-backed terrorism and drug trafficking. Efforts have been made to strengthen border security, enhance intelligence gathering, and improve coordination among various agencies to address these challenges. Time and again, New Delhi has provided evidence that its neighboring country, Pakistan, fosters drug cartels to operate cross-border networks. However, Pakistan refutes these claims.
Pakistan knows that it cannot fight a conventional war with India, and therefore it continues to raise an asymmetric war in which narcotics has a major role to play, because narcotic money is not in formal economy and therefore cannot be caught by FATF. So they keep sending this money. As far as India is concerned, our strategy should be that we should be able to firstly prevent it in entering India by good border fencing, good border defenses, as well as good intelligence, good surveillance, and technologically empowering the border security forces. In addition to that, whoever is caught in India, the punishment should be stringent and the conviction rate must be high.
There are allegations that certain elements within the Pakistani government, military or intelligence agencies turn a blind eye to or even actively facilitate drug trafficking activities conducted by militant groups. The Pakistani government often denies allegations of involvement in narco-terrorism and may deflect blame onto other actors, including neighboring countries or external powers. This denial makes it challenging to address the issue effectively and holds accountable those who may be complicit.
Let's move to Pakistan, where Maulana Fazlur Rahman, the leader of Jamiat Ulema-e-Islam, an Islamist politician, has announced that his party will commemorate the 50th anniversary of the ruling in 1974 that declared Ahmadis to be non-Muslims. The ongoing hostility of the Pakistani state towards the Ahmadi community and other religious minorities in the nation has given people like Maulana Fazlur Rahman more confidence. Minority communities in Pakistan, including Ahmadis, Christians, Hindus and others, have experienced persecution and targeted violence in addition to discrimination in the workplace and educational system. Look at this report.
ये सन 1974 के 7 सितंबर के कादियानियों को गैर मुस्लिम कर लिए करार देने वाली तरमीम का 50वां साल होगा.
This Islamist politician in Pakistan is declaring that his party would celebrate the 50th anniversary of the 1974 decision to declare Ahmadis as non-Muslims. In an address to a conference on the Palestinian issue, Jamiat Ulema-e-Islam chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman is announcing that his party would hold a grand event at the Lahore's Tower, Minare, Pakistan, on September 7 this year. Ironically, Maulana Fazlur Rahman is an active politician who was also the leader of the opposition in Pakistan from 2004 to 2007.
7 September 2024 ye san 1974 ke 7 September ke qadianiyon ko gair muslim kar liye qarar dene wali tarmeem ka 50वां साल होगा. और इस पर मैं ऐलान करता हूं मीनारे पाकिस्तान पर गोल्डन जुबली बनाई जाएगी और पूरे मुल्क आएगा इंशाल्लाह उसमें तो साथ
ताजदारे खत्मे नबूवत हर कूद जाना चाहिए ताजदारे खत्मे नबूवत ताजो दखत खत्मे नबूवत.
People like Maulana Fazlur Rahman have been emboldened by the Pakistani state's continued hatred towards Ahmadi community and other religious minorities in the country. Minority communities in Pakistan such as Christians, Hindus, Ahmadis and others have faced challenges ranging from discrimination in employment and education to targeted violence and persecution. Ahmadi community, which was officially declared non-Muslims 4 decades ago, is increasingly under attack. Moreover, instances of anti-Semitic propaganda, conspiracy theories, and hate speech can be found in certain segments of Pakistani society, including in media, religious discourse, and online platforms. Such attitudes often fuel intolerance and contribute to a hostile environment for Jewish individuals and communities both within Pakistan and globally. As a result, several in Pakistan openly support the Palestinian Sunni Islamist Party Hamas, which is responsible for widespread violence and death in and outside Israel. Maulana Fazl defended the Hamas raid on Israel, saying it was carried out to make the world aware of the plight of Palestinians.
Hamas ne hamla karke dobara se Palestine ke qazie ko ujagar kiya hai. Palestine ko azad karne ka mauzu ye dobara upar aa gaya hai. Aur har chand ke wo kehta hai ki hamare maqbooza ilaqe hamari difai zarurat hai, jiska maana ye hai ki wo piche jaane ke liye taiyar nahi honge. लेकिन दुनिया हमास की तरफ से गजा की तरफ से शुरू की जाने वाली जंग को आजादी फिलिस्तीन की तरफ एक कदम तसव्वुर करते हैं.
On October 7 last year, in an unprecedented surprise attack on a major Jewish holiday, Hamas militants stormed into nearby Israeli towns from the blockaded Gaza Strip, backed by a barrage of rockets. They killed dozens of people and kidnapped more. Since then, an armed conflict between Israel and Hamas-led Palestinian groups has been taking place.
In the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, the Indian Security Forces are vigorously conducting a series of anti-terror operations aimed at dismantling the network of Pakistan-backed terrorism that has plagued the area. The forces are combing through the dense vegetation where terrorists have sought refuge. The operation has garnered high-level attention, with senior officers from the CRPF and Indian Army personally overseeing the search efforts on the ground. This operation follows the tragic loss of Village Defence Guard Muhammad Sharif in gunfight with the terrorists. A report.
On April 28, a Village Defence Guard was fatally injured in a gunfight between the police and a group of hiding terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir's Udhampur district. The injured VDG member later succumbed to his injuries in the hospital. He has been identified as Muhammad Sharif, a resident of Basantgarh, Udhampur. Village Defence Guards, once known as Village Defence Committee, are armed civilian group set up in Jammu and Kashmir border areas to ward off terrorist attack. The guards are provided with guns and ammunition to tackle terrorists in case of an attack until security forces reach the particular area. According to police officials, two groups of terrorists have infiltrated from across the border.
सभी जगह हमने एक्टिवेशन किया, हमने BDGs को एक्टिवेशन किया, और हमारी जब BDG जो हमारे SPO के साथ थी, जो हमारे मेंबरान हैं, हमारे पूरे परिवार की, इन्होंने जब इलाके में गश्त की, इलाके में एरिया डोमिनेशन एक्सरसाइज शुरू की, तो उस गश्त में आतंकवादियों ने इन पे हमला किया। जवाबी कार्रवाई हमारी पार्टी ने भी की, और उसमें है एक हमारा एक साथी, उसमें एक शहीद हुआ है, और पूरे इलाके की घेराबंदी हमने की है, और उसमें सर्च जारी है।
In response to this attack, CRPF as well as para commandos cordoned off a wide area and guarded all the escape routes. According to reports, a massive search operation is underway, and senior police and army officers are monitoring the operation themselves, but no trace of the terrorists have been found yet. Security forces are using an unmanned aerial vehicle to track down the terrorists who are hiding, taking cover of thick vegetation.
हमारी जो सर्च पार्टीज हैं वो इस वक्त डीप जंगल्स में सर्च कर रही हैं, जो आसपास के इलाके हैं जहां डोके हैं वहां पे सर्च कर रही हैं, और इसके अलावा हमारे जो जितने भी सारे सहयोगी फोर्सेस हैं उसके साथ हमारे काफी सारे अपने JKP के एलिमेंट्स हैं, वो सब इसमें लगे हुए हैं। ड्रोन सर्विलेंस जो है वो हमने पुशन की है, और सर्च फिलहाल जारी है।
इन रिसेंट ईयर्स देयर हैव बीन ऑनगोइंग सिक्योरिटी चैलेंजेस इन इंडियाज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर रीजन due to infiltration attempts by militants. These attempts involve terrorists crossing the line of control from Pakistan-occupied territory. Pakistan is providing training and funding to terrorists to infiltrate into Jammu and Kashmir and carry out attacks on security forces and civilians. Infiltrators often use rugged and mountainous terrain to evade Indian security forces and carry out attacks on targets within Indian territory. Pakistan's support for terrorist groups in Jammu and Kashmir is seen as part of its broader strategy of using proxy warfare to exert pressure on India and pursue its agenda in the region. However, the Indian security forces have been engaged in counter-insurgency operations to thwart these infiltration attempts and to maintain peace and stability in the region.
In Gilgit-Baltistan, hope wanes under the weight of an unjust regime. Residents witness a systematic exploitation of their resources and taxation. Imposed without a voice in governance amplifies their sense of alienation. Environmental anxieties add another layer to their discontent. Locals fear not just displacement, but also the irreversible damage of their fragile ecosystems, which sustain their way of life. The protests echoing through Gilgit-Baltistan's valleys and peaks are not just merely about immediate grievances, they are a collective cry for dignity. A report.
Gilgit-Baltistan has been illegally occupied by Islamabad for more than 7 decades. Residents of this region have endured the worst of Pakistan's political and economic hardships for many years. People complain that successive administrations in Gilgit-Baltistan have failed to address even the most basic necessities. Unfair taxation, an unprecedented increase in the price of food items, and regular power cuts have perturbed the locals. They blame Pakistan and its stooge administration for looting the vital resources of the region.
हमारे पानी से पूरा पाकिस्तान सराब हो रहा है सर हमारा पानी सारा पाकिस्तान में जाता है गिलगित बल्तिस्तान में बिजली का है ही नहीं सिरे से नहीं है बिजली कहीं डैम लगाते किधर जाता है पता नहीं है बिजली पहले कहते थे गुरु आ गया बिजली का लोड शेडिंग खत्म हो गया नल तर आ गया 14 आ गया 14 के बाद 20 आ गया अभी क्या कब्रिस्तान आएगा इधर क्या करेंगे सर बिजली ही नहीं है कुछ भी नहीं है
The residents say the incumbent chief minister Gulbar Khan has done nothing to improve their lives. For decades, the living conditions in Gilgit-Baltistan have deteriorated. They reckon they have seen no development in the region during Gulbar Khan's regime. The skyrocketing inflation and rising electricity bills have broken their backs.
अभी तक तो हाजी गुलबर साहब की कोई कारकर्दगी हमें नज़र नहीं आ रही है क्योंकि यहाँ पे कोई डेवलपमेंट काम हो नहीं रहा है इसलिए कि सीएम साहब उसकी पता नहीं सेहत भी अच्छी नहीं है वो इधर बैठता है नहीं बैठता ये भी हमें पता नहीं होता है कि एक वजीर आला को तो हर वक्त जनाब अपने ऑफिस में बैठना चाहे आवाम के मसाइल हल करना चाहे वो तो पूरे जी बी का चीफ मिनिस्टर है तो इस वक्त जी बी की हालत ये है कि बस सब कुछ आवे का आवा बिगड़ा हुआ है कोई मतलब उनकी कारकर्दगी नजर नहीं आ रही है
Despite continuous protests throughout Gilgit-Baltistan against inflation, electricity bills and numerous other issues in the last year, the locals got no reprieve. Often treated as second-class citizens, the residents of Gilgit-Baltistan have no representation in the political and bureaucratic processes in their own land.
इनका कोई कारकर्दगी नहीं है अभी तक देखा जाए तो लाइट का इशू आपको पता है गर्मियां स्टार्ट हो गई है अभी तक लाइट का नामो निशान नहीं है 24 घंटे में से 23 घंटे लोड शेडिंग हो रही है इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के ऊपर कोई काम नहीं हो रहा है एजुकेशन सिस्टम तबाह है स्कूलों में पूछने वाला कोई नहीं है ब्यूरोक्रेसी को आए रोज तब्दील किया जा रहा है और इनके पास कोई अवामी मैंडेट नहीं है इसी वजह से ये आपको पता है इस्टेब्लिशमेंट के बल बोते पे आए हैं तो ये बस अपने मज़े में लगे हुए
आज रेट कुछ और रहता है कल को रोज और होता है हर दिन रेट में फर्क पड़ता है आज जाते सामान लेते तो कल उसका रेट कुछ और होता है हर दिन बे दिन बढ़ाते और कम करता नहीं एक रुपये सस्ता किया 10 महंगा करते हैं
Their hopes and aspirations of a better life have died down under the illegitimate and draconian regime of Pakistan. The residents have realized well that the successive administrations in Gilgit-Baltistan are deployed to siphon off their natural resources and destroy even the basic urge to live in their own territory. Locals are angry over the fact that Pakistani government is imposing taxes on them without providing them with adequate representation in the country's legislative bodies. They argue that since Gilgit-Baltistan lacks full constitutional rights and representation in Pakistan's parliament, they should not be subjected to taxation without proper representation. Additionally, there have been protests related to environmental issues, such as concerns about the impact of infrastructure projects on the region's natural resources and ecosystems. The protests in Gilgit-Baltistan reflect the aspirations of its residents for greater autonomy, representation, and respect for their rights.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We'll be back next week with more news, views, and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shivangi Mishra signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.